Channel 6 at 5, safety concerns in one Augusta neighborhood. What's being done to fight crime in that area?
Plus, it's World Mental Health Day, and tonight, we're taking a look at resources available locally for mental health services.
And it is Fire Prevention Week. Advice from the Red Cross to keep your home safe as Your News at 5 starts now.
Live from Television Park, this is WJBF News Channel 6 at 5.
Good evening, everybody. I'm Brad Means.
And I'm Jenny Montgomery. Thanks for joining us.
Coverage You Can Count On begins with a look at the safety of one Richmond County neighborhood, one that's been hit hard by violent crime in the past few years. News Channel 6's Renetta Dubose talked to leaders and people who live in that area about the efforts being made to reduce crime. She is joining us live now off Wrightsboro Road. Renetta?
Brad, there's a new name and even new features here at the former Fox Den to make it safer. So we spoke with the commissioners working with this new owner as well as people who live here to find out if it's working.
I was at home, he was calling me, and he wanted me to come outside and stuff. But then somebody was at the store, and they shot me, whatever.
A 16-year-old who only wants to be identified as Monica lost a close friend September 30th to gun violence. That friend was 17-year-old Zaquantes Jones, shot and killed at the Smart Grocery near the Landings at 237 apartment complex off Wrightsboro Road. She tells us that murder and other crimes have been her reality at home since she was in third grade.
It was basically the same, a lot of crime out here, but it just got worse. Shooters, basically. It's all that happened out here, shooters.
Augusta Commissioners John Clark and Catherine McKnight tell News Channel 6 they have been working with the owner to reduce crime. Clark confirmed off camera that the new 8-foot wooden fence completely around the property, 2 Flock safety surveillance cameras, and security gates, both for cars and pedestrians operated by code, are all up.
This particular owner has taken extreme measures to meet with us commissioners, wants to meet, know the sheriff's department, and wants to be involved with the marshal, and wants to have a good rapport with us and work together.
As a thank you, and much to their surprise, Clark and McKnight tell us the owner affixed their names and the city logo to a camouflage surveillance tower with the words, "Keeping Augusta Safe." It sparked criticism and support online, and McKnight tells us she understands both sides. We spoke with people who live in the Landings at 237 about whether the recent efforts have worked.
The little bird tower up there, and that kind of helped a little bit keep the traffic in and out from the store to there.
So that surveillance tower helped?
A little bit, yeah. Because, you know, you don't hear the shooting or nothing like that. The other night I was sitting out, I heard a couple shots, but it was nothing.
Because regardless of who you catch, who did the shooting, who did this and that and third, there's still going to be more people out here that's going to do the same thing. You can't change nobody or their mindset. What they going to do?
Now, we spoke with the staff on site to see if the surveillance tower, which is now gone, will return, but no word from that owner. We also reached out to the sheriff's office to see if its numbers show that there is a crime reduction. Live in Augusta, Renetta Dubose, WJBF News Channel 6.
Renetta, thank you for that report. Lots of money from Augusta's stormwater program is going down the drain. The city has been charging a stormwater fee since 2016, but not every customer pays. The city's top 5 delinquent accounts show 2 bills behind by more than $50,000, and the total for all 5 is more than $200,000.
When you take into account there's $200,000 that hasn't been spent, really, when you look at it, that's one more time that the contractors could cut all of the right-of-ways. I mean, that's a big amount of money. So when you look at it in real terms like that, that shortfall creates some other issues for, you know, the rest of the county.
Under city policy, unpaid accounts can be turned over to a collection agency, but none of these accounts has been turned over. City engineers say that soon will happen.
We are still waiting to find out the name of a man who was shot to death early this morning in South Augusta. He was pronounced dead at the Circle K on Peach Orchard Road, the 2800 block of Peach Orchard. About 3 o'clock in the morning, the coroner, Mark Bowen, tells us the victim had been shot at least once. They're going to do an autopsy, and so far, no word on suspects.
One person is in custody charged with an armed robbery in Burke County. It happened around 4:30 this morning at the Taylor's Brothers Express on the 3900 block of Highway 25. Deputies spotted a vehicle matching the clerk's description. They tried to get the suspect stopped, but they say the driver refused. After a chase, the driver crashed his vehicle on Liberty Street and ran. 24-year-old James Douglas Drayton from Spartanburg was captured a few minutes later, arrested, and now faces several charges. It is time now for a check of our forecast. Early voting in the Palmetto State will take place October 24th through November 5th. Election Day is set for Tuesday, November 8th.
Today is World Mental Health Awareness Day. News Channel 6's Tiffany Hobbs spoke with local advocates about the work being done in our community and the resources that are out there to those in need.
In the past 2 years, the need for mental health services has risen significantly. Local providers are working hard to address a growing demand to support those in need.
Dr. Richard Camino Gastambide is a psychiatrist and training director of psychiatry and the general residency program at AU and NCG. One way they are addressing the need is through free mental health services for the community one Tuesday each month.
Right now, we're seeing about 10 patients per per month, but we have about 150 patients that have from June to now come to the clinic and wanting to receive services and being served by us.
If you or anyone you know is in need of mental health services, you can find resources at WJBF.com. In Augusta, Tiffany Hobbs, WJBF News Channel 6.
It is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. There are campaigns everywhere encouraging women to get what could be a life-saving mammogram. Last October, we told you about the little-known federally funded breast and cervical cancer program and the services it provides. Dozens of women saw the story and decided to take advantage of the program. Lisa Ann Wheeler, the patient navigator for the BCCP program, says one of the women found out she had early-stage breast cancer and it was treatable.
So we set up her appointment. She came in and had her annual exam, had her mammogram, and she was diagnosed with breast cancer. But had she not seen the segment, and had she not come in and gotten her mammogram, then she would still have breast cancer, not even know, and not have the access that she needed to get to her mammogram.
Wheeler encourages all women over 40 to get their mammogram and not to let fear or circumstance stop them. For more information on the program and to see if you qualify, just go to our website, WJBF.com.
And just a reminder, the Miracle Mile Walk is this Saturday, starts at the Augusta Common. You can bring donations down there starting at 7:30 Saturday morning. And then the program starts at 8. The actual walk starts at 9. And you can donate if you'd like to at themiraclemilewalk.org.
Coming up, South Carolina state leaders meeting today to discuss how to bring in more teachers.
Big concern there. The state's new task force trying to really make some headway. As News Channel 6 at 5 continues.
Clover Health. Why not?
Happening now, state leaders looking at ways to keep certified and high-quality teachers in your child's classroom.
A new recruitment and retention task force met in Columbia for the first time. Jason Raven was there and has more.
Educators say it's one of the most pressing issues facing education in South Carolina right now, the teacher shortage. This year, state lawmakers created the Teacher Recruitment and Retention Task Force with a one-year budget proviso. It's made up of state lawmakers, state education officials, future, current, and former teachers. They will study and consider policies that increase recruitment to the teaching profession, improve teacher prep, transform compensation for teachers, enhance the effectiveness of teacher evaluation, and improve working conditions for all teachers.
Work we're going to have to do is things outside of the budget and outside of salaries. And certainly I want y'all to bring us your information and your ideas on that. But we're going to have to do other things that goes beyond salaries.
Now, no date has been set for the task force next meeting. In Columbia, I'm Jason Raven.
It is Fire Prevention Week. News Channel 6's Hannah Latier spoke with one local woman who hopes her story can help save lives.
I feel like if it hadn't been for the Lord, I would have never got that fire put out because, you know, I wouldn't have really known what to do. But I thought, well, God, I'm going to try.
Leo Amburn and her husband woke up to the smell of smoke early Sunday morning and found that there was a guitar amplifier on fire in one of the rooms in their house.
I said, move, I'll do it myself. I said, I'll do it. So I went into my kitchen, grabbed a pot, and filled it up with water and kept throwing pots of water on it.
Shortly after that, she told us the Aiken County Fire Department and volunteers from the American Red Cross showed up to help put out the flames and offer financial support.
We want to meet with them, we've got to process the information, but just to discuss everything, make sure everything's covered. And then there's also the financial transaction, making sure that everything's handled correctly on that to get them that support.
Red Cross gave the couple gift cards to replace any personal items lost in the fire and to help cover the cost of damages. Leah wants other homeowners to learn from her experience.
If you're not using something, make certain you cut it off or unplug it, whichever you feel more secure in.
According to the Red Cross, the number of house fires rises during the fall and winter seasons, and they're urging people to test their smoke alarms and have an escape plan in place.
Having a fire alarm is so important because it can happen to anybody. We've been to trailer homes, to very nice houses that catch on fire, and happens, and it's an accident. Nobody plans for this, and you're stuck trying to recover.
You can contact 1-800-RED-CROSS for additional support. In Aiken, Hannah Letier, WJBF News Channel 6.
Up next, our chief meteorologist Tim Miller back with your 5-6 forecast.
Plus, it may be only October, but some retailers are already rolling out holiday shopping deals. Stay with us.
I'm attorney. Cooler Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and then our next system comes at the end of next week, which I think will be a significant cool down for us with highs only in the 60s.
Be nice when we get to do that for a while, especially during fair week then.
Yes.
Well, the holiday season is still weeks away, but some stores are already rolling out shopping deals. Yeah, from November 1st through the end of the year, Adobe expecting U.S. online holiday sales to top $200 billion, about a 2.5% increase from last year. Experts say a projected pullback in spending has stores already offering those discounts.
So our expectation is, while the shopping season may start earlier with discounting, retailers are likely to respond with more aggressive discounts. And we've seen that in our data so far this year as we lead into the holiday season.
Amazon launching its new fall shopping event tomorrow. They'll promote deals on Amazon-branded electronics and products from companies including Hasbro, KitchenAid, and Samsung. When we come back, we'll introduce you to this month's winner of the Giving Your Best Award.
She's the founder of a mentoring group for teenage girls, and as you'll see, it's full circle giving back for Walisa Langford.
Imagine if you...
People remember ads with young people having a good time, so to help you remember...
It is time now to meet your October winner of the Giving Your Best Award. Walisa Langford is the founder of Precious Pearls Mentoring. That's an extracurricular group that provides guidance for girls as they go through their adolescent years. She believes all young girls need a positive influence in their life and shouldn't always look to social media for influencers. She says that she stays motivated even when she wants to throw in the towel because someone did it for her. Mentoring 11 to 18-year-old girls is a big task, but Walisa Langford is up to the challenge. For her, it's about giving back, because life was challenging when she was that age. She was a foster child.
I've had people in my life that, you know, guided me and stuck with me, even through my bad attitudes, you know, my misbehaviors. They stuck with me, they prayed for me, and they guided me. So I wanted to be that light for some of the youth that are going through some challenges that we see today. Oftentimes, people turn their back on the youth because they're disrespectful, you know, they don't know how to act, but it's all because, to me, they're lacking love.
No wonder Walisa's nominator said she walks the walk and talks the talk. She's lived it.
Like, what you see is what you get. If I say I'm going to do something, I'm going to do it. If I'm not going to do it, I'm not going to do it. And a lot of kids, they look before anything else. They look at your actions before they hear your words.
Piggyback on what she said, the commitment of
which it does for these young ladies. I also work with the youth. I'm a bus driver, so I know that they need a program like this that, you know, could help them through the tough times.
And that's the purpose of Precious Pearls Mentoring Group for Girls.
We meet weekly, and our goal is to basically just support, uplift, and encourage our youth through service, education, and fun fellowship. We're here. We discuss life lessons. If you have a daughter that you feel would benefit from the program, we're here.
It's a big commitment for the whole Lankford family. But Walisa says it's a calling from God, and they make it work.
She's limitless. Sometimes I think she gives too much. I'm like, all right, now, you can't do, you know, that. You know, but, you know, I understand at the same time.
Walisa Lankford, working mother, wife, godmother, group leader, and mentor. In so many ways, she is the one who's precious to others. Do you know someone who deserves the Giving Your Best Award? If so, nominate them on our Giving Your Best Facebook page or on our website, WJBF.com. You can also mail your nomination to the address on your screen. News Channel 6 at 5:30 is next.
A lot goes into taking care.